President, please be seated.
Président, veuillez vous asseoir.
The court
is now in session. Today, the chamber hears the testimony of a witness to TCW 887. We also wish to inform the parties that this witness requires the support of a TPO staff.
Les parties que ce témoin
during the testimony and the chamber agrees to the request.
Sa déposition et la chambre
and Wiser is responsible for coordinating the TPO staff. Mr. Ji Si Huang, please report the attendance of the parties and other individuals at today's proceedings. Gracias. Mr. President, for today's proceedings,
Monsieur
all parties to this case are present.
Toutes les parties au procès sont présentes.
Nunchi is present in the holding cell in the waiting room downstairs as he waves to where he is there is present in the courtroom. His waiver has been delivered to the greffier. The witness who is to testify today, that is to TCW 887, confirms that through his knowledge he has no relationship by blood or by law to any of the two accused. There is no GNK some pawn or to any of the civil parties admitted in this case. The witness took an oath before the Iron Club statute this morning, and there is no reserved witness today. President, thank you, and the chamber now decides on the request by Nun Chia. The chamber has received a waiver from Nun Chia, dated 4 June 2015, which states that due to his health, that is headache, back pain, he cannot sit or concentrate for long, and in order to effectively participate in future hearings, he requests to waive his rights to participate in and be present at the 4 June 2015 hearing. Having seen the medical report of Nun Chi by the duty doctor for the accused at the ECCC, dated 4 June 2015, who notes that Nun Chi has a chronic back pain when he sits for long and dizziness when he moves, and recommends that the chamber so grant him his request so that he can follow the proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs. Based on the above information and pursuant to Rule 81.5 of the ECCC internal rules, the chamber grants Nun Chi his request to follow the proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs via and audiovisual means. The AV unit personnel are instructed to link the proceedings to the room downstairs so that Nun Chi can follow the proceedings remotely. That applies for the whole day.
Est valable toute la journée.
Court officer, please usher the witness as well as the TPO staff into the courtroom.
Témoin, ainsi que le membre du TPO dans le prétoire.
President. Good morning, Madam Witness. What is your name?
Bonjour. Comment vous nommez-vous?
Witness, my name is Sou Soeurn.
Je me nomme Sou Soeurn.
President, thank you, Madam Sou Soeurn.
Sou Soeurn.
When were you born?
Quelle est votre date de naissance?
Answer, I cannot recall it.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
Question, how old are you this year?
Question, quel âge avez-vous cette année?
Answer, I am 79 years old.
J'ai 79 ans.
Question, when were you born?
Question, quand êtes-vous né?
Answer, I was born in Chuk Sai Village,
Chuk
Sai Commune, Barai District, Kampong Thum Province.
Chuk Sai District de Barai, Province de
Kampong Thum. Where is your current address?
Question, quelle est votre adresse?
Answer, currently I lived in Anlong Veng, Commune, Anlong Veng District. Question, what is your current occupation?
Quel est votre travail aujourd'hui? Votre
Answer,
réponse.
I don't have any job at the moment.
Je suis sans emploi à l'heure
Question,
actuelle.
What are the names of
Question,
your
quels
parents?
Sont les noms de vos parents?
Answer,
réponse.
My father is Lum Saib and my mother is Doi Thu.
Ma mère se nomme Doi Thu.
Question, what is your
Question,
husband's name and how many children do you have?
Combien d'enfants avez-vous avec lui?
Answer, my husband
Réponse,
is Kai Po.
Mon mari se nomme
We
Kai
have
Po.
Six children.
Nous avons six enfants.
President, thank you, Madame Sou Soeurn.
President, je vous remercie, Madame Sou Soeurn.
The graduate made an oral report that, to your best knowledge, you are not related by blood or by law to any of the two accused, that is Nguyen Chi and Kirsten Porn, or any of the civil parties admitted in this case. Is the information accurate?
Des parties civiles en l'espèce. Est-ce que cette information est exacte?
And I am not related to any of them.
Réponse, je n'ai aucun
Question.
Lien de parenté
the greffier
avec
also
personnes.
Said that you already took an
Question.
Oath before your appearance this morning.
Le greffier a également
Is that
dit
true?
Que vous avez prêté serment avant de comparaître ce matin. Est-ce exact?
Answer, yes.
Réponse, oui.
President, the chamber now would like to inform you of your rights and obligations as a witness. Madame Sou Soeurn, as a witness in the proceedings before the chamber, you may refuse to respond to any question or to make any comment which may incriminate you, and that is your right against self-incrimination, and this means that you may refuse to provide your response or make any comments that could lead you to being prosecuted. And Madame Sou Soeurn, now on your obligations. As a witness in the proceedings before the chamber, you may respond to any questions by the bench or relevant parties, except where your response or comments to those questions may incriminate you, as the chamber has just informed you of your right as a witness. Also, as a witness, you must tell the truth that you have known, heard, seen, remembered, experienced, or observed directly in relation to any event or circumstance relevant to the question that a bench or parties posed to you. And Madame Sou Soeurn, have you been interviewed by investigators of the Office of the Co-Investigating Judges? If so, how many times, when, and where? Answer, I was interviewed once at Anlong Veng.
Réponse, j'ai été entendu une fois à Anlong Veng.
question. And before
question.
You entered the courtroom,
et avant d'entrer dans le prétoire,
have you reviewed your written records of your statement, or do you have it read out aloud to you in order to refresh your memory?
Été lu à haute voix afin de vous rafraîchir la mémoire?
And I asked my younger sibling to read it aloud to me. Questioned, and to your best knowledge, does the written record of your interview reflect the statements you made before the OCIJ investigators at Anlong Weng? And now I tend to forget a lot, and in the past I can recall a lot of things. President, this is not what I
meant.
After you have your written record of interview read aloud to you by your younger sibling, that is regarding your interview at Anlong Weng, does that written record reflect what you spoke to the investigators at the time?
Answer,
yes, it reflects what I said, but now I tend to forget a lot.
J'ai tendance à oublier beaucoup.
President, pursuant to Rule 91 bis of the ECCC Internal Rules, the chamber give the floor to the co-prosecutors first to put question to this witness, and the combined time for the co-prosecutors and the lead co-lawyers for civil party is 3 sessions, and the co-prosecutor, you have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honors, counsel. Madam Witness, I'll be putting questions to you this morning. My name is Dale Lysak. I'm one of the prosecutors at the court. I want to start with some questions about your and your husband's background. You stated in your OCIJ interview document E3-5294 that you were married to your husband Kai Pok when you were 22 years old. By my calculation, if you're 79 today, you were born around 1936, which would mean that you were married to your husband around 1958. Is that correct? Do you remember the year when you and Kai Pok were married?
Allow me to respond.
Réponse. Permettez-moi de répondre.
I had a child in 1962, and that was 3 years after our marriage.
3 ans après notre mariage.
Thank you. Can you tell us where you and Kai Pok lived after you were married? And also, can you tell us whether he was already part of the revolution at the time you were married?
No, he did not at the time, as he was still engaged in rice farming.
Il était toujours agriculteur.
And where was it that you and your husband
Question.
Lived after you
Et
were married
in
1959?
59.
I live in Chuk Ksach, that is in Barai district, Kampong Thom province.
Dans le district de Barai, province de Kampong Thom.
Madam Witness, your husband gave an interview before his death, which I'm going to read to you from time to time today to see if that helps refresh your recollection on some matters. That interview is a document E3/2782, also E3/2783, just so the parties are aware that the same interview is in two different documents and the French translation is only in the second document. That's why I'll be referring to both E3 numbers. The ERN reference I would like to read to you is at English 00089708, Khmer 00095547, and French 00596203. In this interview, Kai Pak, your husband, starts by describing his background as follows. Quote, I joined the struggle since 1949 in the Khmer Hissarak period. After the Geneva Convention, I abandoned the struggle and returned home. In 1957, Su Heng, the secretary of the party, contacted me and told me to rejoin the struggle. I did so and enlisted into the party in Svai Ti sub-district, Chamkar Lu district. Continuing in the next paragraph, in 1958, after I became a member of the party, they assigned me to conduct some activities in Chamkar Lu district, my birthplace. End of quote. Let me ask you just a couple of things here. First of all, is it correct that your husband came from Chamkar Lu district?
I am not sure at this point, and I did not know when he joined the revolution.
Do you remember whether you moved to Chamkar Lu district at some point after you and Kai Pak were married?
Une fois que vous avez été marié à Kai Pak, vous avez déménagé à Chamkar Lu.
After our marriage, we went to live in Prekmih village,
Chamkar
Lu, Chamkar Nung district.
The next page of your husband's interview, he describes some events from the 1960s relating to the Communist Party of Kampuchea, and he states, quote, in mid-1967, the Zone Committee was composed of Khoi Tun as secretary, and I, the deputy secretary, and Dun Sreng Bra Tung and Samat as members. At that time, Brother Nguyen was away to pray chore to assign forces. In 1968, I began working in the jungle. End of quote. First question, did you go with your husband to the jungle in 1968, or did you and your children live somewhere else at that time?
At that time,
I did not stay with him. We lived separately since 1967.
The statement from your husband that I just read refers to Brother Nguyen organizing or assigning forces in Prachor district. Did you know Nguyen Chea during this time period? And do you remember the first time that you met Nguyen Chea?
Vous souvenez-vous de la première fois où vous avez rencontré Nguyen Chea?
I did not know him yet, and I got to know him only when I was in Phnom Penh.
And when was it that you lived in Phnom Penh? And could you tell us about how you got to know Nguyen Chea when you were living in Phnom Penh?
That was the time when I came to earn a living in Phnom Penh.
C'est à ce moment-là que je suis venue gagner ma vie à Phnom Penh.
And I was called to be a cook.
On m'a demandé d'être cuisinière.
And I apologize if I cannot recall the details of the event.
Et je m'excuse, je ne me souviens pas des détails de cet événement.
You stated in the first answer of your OCIJ interview, E3-5294, that you joined the revolution in 1969 while you were living in Phnom Penh. Can you tell us whether it was in connection with joining the revolution in Phnom Penh that you first met Nguyen Chea?
Avec cela que vous avez rencontré Nguyen Chea.
Dạ, về lúc khi ông bạn cái hai khi ông mau chui đầm bài đầm bảy.
I was called to be a cook, and that was the time I got to know him.
On m'a demandé de venir travailler en tant que cuisinière. C'est à ce moment-là que je l'ai rencontré.
And of course, they discuss about the work. But I did not understand about the nature of the work, so I started to become a cook for them.
Donc je suis devenue cuisinière pour eux.
And could you tell us you were cooking for Nguyen Chea and other people? Can you tell us who it was that you were cooking for at that time?
I did not see him. I cooked in the kitchen, and it was someone else who took the food to him.
In the same answer, your first answer of your OCIJ interview, you describe how you left Phnom Penh with your daughter to join the Maquis in October 1970, and how you were taken to a location in the deep forest near the Stung Chinit River where you met your husband. The location where you met your husband near the Chinit River, was this a location where a number of party leaders were located? Was this a headquarters or base of the party?
Était-ce là une des bases, un des bastions du parti?
It was a military headquarters, and I did not see any senior leaders there. I only saw military
commander.
Who were the military commanders who were at that location?
Qui étaient les commandants militaires que vous avez vus là-bas?
It related to the work of my husband.
Réponse, l'avait trait au travail de mon mari.
And can you tell us a little bit about what your role, what the role or work of your husband was at the time you joined him in the maquis?
À l'époque où vous l'avez rejoint dans le maquis.
At that time, his position was simply a cadre.
À cette époque-là, il était simplement cadre.
When you went to live in the forest in 1970, did your son, K-Pick Vanak, did he live in the same location as you?
Vivait au même endroit que vous? Réponse.
Yes. Initially, my son lived in Kampong Cham, and I went to that location along with my daughter.
Et je suis allée à cet endroit avec ma fille.
I want to read to you an excerpt from the interview of your son. It's document E3/35 at Khmer 00340560-61, English 00346147, French 00367718-719. And this is part of his first answer in his OCIJ interview. He testified that between 1970 and 1973, he lived at a site in Stung Trong district, Kampong Cham. That was the party center headquarters. That during the day, he was taught by Pol Pot's wife, Hu Ponnery, who he called Grand Aunt Ri, and that at night he would give massages to Pol Pot, who he referred to as Grand Uncle Sar, alias Grand Uncle Pol. My question for you, Madam Witness, did you have regular contact with Pol Pot and his wife, like your son, during the 1970 to 73
time period?
Personally, I
did not
close to them.
Réponse. Personnellement, je n'étais pas très proche
de. We stayed in the forest together. I was not close to him, and I did not know how close my son was to them.
Je ne sais pas si mon fils était proche d'eux ou pas.
Did you see Pol Pot and his wife from time to time during those years?
Avez-vous vu Pol Pot et sa femme de temps en temps à cette époque?
Answer.
Réponse.
I met them when I was living in the forest.
Lorsque je vivais dans la jungle.
I met them sometime,
je and
they were
de
referred
temps
as Bong.
Et
when I was allowed to
Bong.
Go and meet them, I could go to see them.
Lorsque l'on me donnait la permission de
although
le faire,
we
je pouvais
lived
aller les
in
voir.
The for in the same forest.
Nous vivions dans la même forêt.
In his OCIJ interview,
question,
again at Khmer 00340561, English 00346148, French 00367719. Your son testified that he also saw a Kyu Sempan at the party headquarters in the forest. when he lived there between 1970 and 1973. He referred to Kyusum Pan as Grand Uncle Ham. My question for you, did you also see Kyusum Pan at that location during those years?
Answer. It appears that I did not meet him.
Je ne l'ai pas rencontré.
As I stated, my son was living in a separate place. So
mon fils vivait ailleurs.
If he met, I did not know about that.
Il l'a peut-être rencontré, mais je n'en ai rien su.
I may have met him or those people once in a while.
J'ai peut-être rencontré ces personnes de temps en temps.
Do you remember, Madam Witness, the Question. First time that
Madame
you met Kyusum Pan?
Vous souvenez-vous de la première fois où vous avez rencontré Kyusum Pan?
Answer. I do not recall it.
Réponse. Je ne m'en souviens pas.
I do not recall when I met him and where I met him.
Je ne me souviens pas du moment ni du lieu où je l'ai rencontré.
I want to move now to the period beginning in 17
April
1975.
Dans la
and
de,
I first want to ask you about
1975.
What your husband's, read you an excerpt from your husband's interview. This is again
E3,
2782 and 2783. ERN references Khmer 000955550 through 51. English 00089711 through 712. And French 00596208.
And
in this document, your husband states that after 17 April 1975, he became the secretary of what was then the North Zone, and what would later become the Central Zone. And he also states that Khoi Thun, who had been the secretary of the zone, was transferred to Phnom Penh to the Ministry of Commerce. My question for you, did your husband ever tell you why he was promoted to zone secretary
and
Khoi Thun was sent to the Ministry of Commerce after the 17th of April 1975?
Answer. What I knew is that my husband became the zone secretary, and I did not know about the arrangement of his position. As I stated, as a female, I was not allowed to know the affairs in detail.
Do you remember how you first learned
Question.
That your husband had
Et
been appointed the North Zone secretary?
La première fois que votre mari avait été nommé secrétaire de la zone?
Answer, I do not know.
Réponse, je ne sais pas.
From that time onwards, I heard people addressed him
à partir
as
de ce
such.
Moment-là, j'ai entendu les gens
I asked him about that, and my husband told me that I had to mind my own business, and others they cared their own business already.
Les autres faisaient de même.
And I want to go through the positions
Question.
That you held in the party through the Democratic Kampuchea regime.
Du Kampuchea démocratique.
In your OCIJ
Dans
interview, E3/5294 at Khmer 00348827, English 00360111, French 00367803. You state that you were initially a village chief during the 1970 to 75 period, and that at the start of the Khmer Rouge regime, quote, when Phnom Penh was liberated, I stayed at Prasap district of Kampon Cham. At that time, they made me a member of the Prasap district committee, and I was put in charge of receiving evacuees from Phnom Penh. End of quote. Madam Witness, during that time period,
Madame le témoin,
was Prasap district
époque,
part of
le district
a
de
sector 42 of the north
du zone? 42 de la zone nord?
Answer, I could not have the graphs of the information. Perhaps it was under that.
Je n'en sais rien.
Perhaps it was the same as what you stated, but I do not remember it.
C'était peut-être le cas, mais je ne m'en souviens pas.
Quand President, Deputy Co-Plusk,
and
Deputy Co-Prosecutor of the National Side, please verify the name. I heard that the name was mentioned as Prasad, but actually there was no Prasad, there was only Prasad.
Il n'y avait que Prasad.
Thank you, Mr. President. Let me clarify. Perhaps I mispronunciate. Was the name of the district that you were appointed to in after April 1975,
Prasap?
Yeah. Answer. Yes.
Réponse.
It was Prasap.
Oui, c'est Prasap.
Let me see if I can refresh your recollection on this.
Si je peux vous
this is another excerpt from your husband's interview, E3/2782 and 2783 at Khmer 00955551, English 00897 13, French 00596 210. Your husband gave a description here of the structure of the central or old north zone. He stated it was divided into three regions, regions 41, 42, and 43. And in regards to region 42, he said it consisted of Tang Kork, Bure, Stung Trang, Champkar Lu, and Prasap districts. Does that refresh your recollection, Madam Witness, that there
Madame
were five districts
présent,
that formed Sector 42, including both Prasap and Champkar Lu?
Il y avait celui de Champkar Lu et celui de Prasap.
Answer, I do not
Réponse.
Recall it.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
I remembered that Prey Prasap and Jamkale
were
within
Jamkale
that
et de
sector.
Prasap. qui faisait partie
I may have remembered that before, but I do not recall it
enfin,
now.
Je m'en souvenais certainement avant, mais je ne m'en souviens plus maintenant.
Fair enough. Going back to the history of your positions.
Très bien, merci. Je reviens au poste que vous avez occupé.
OCIJ dans interview E3 5294, you say that you lived in Prayasap district for approximately half a year, at which time you were sent to Champkarlu district and nominated on the Champkarlu district committee in charge of women. Do I understand correctly that it would have been in the latter part of 1975? Half a year after 17 April 1975, that you moved to Champkarlu district and became a member of that district committee.
Pour y faire partie du comité du district.
Answer. It is correct.
Réponse. Oui, c'est exact.
I stayed in Prayasap district for half a year and I was transferred to Champkarlu district after that time. I worked in Champkarlu for 1 year. At that time I was a member of the district committee. There was only one female, that was me at that time.
And in regards to your assignment to Champkarlu district, you stated, quote, I was appointed by the sector secretary. Toll was the sector secretary. My question, Madam Witness, the person you identify as the sector secretary Toll, was he a cousin of your husband?
Cousin de votre mari.
Answer. No.
Réponse. Non.
He was not related to my husband.
Il n'était pas parent de mon mari.
He was living in the same province of my husband's.
La même province que mon mari.
He and my husband were not related.
Mais mon mari et lui n'étaient pas parents.
How long had you known
question.
The sector secretary Toll? How long had you and your husband known him?
Vous, votre mari, le secrétaire du district, ou du secteur plutôt, Toll?
Answer.
Réponse.
I only came to know him when he became
je l'ai connu
the
uniquement
chief of the sector.
Lorsqu'il est devenu
and
chef
as for
du
my
secteur.
Husband, I did not know when
quand
my
mari,
husband knew this individual.
Thank you. You identify in your
merci.
Interview another person who was also on the Champkarlu District Committee by the name of Ban. Can you tell us who Ban was?
Pourriez-vous nous dire qui était ce Ban?
Answer. Ban
réponse.
Was a villager. He lived
Ban était un villageois
close to a river
qui vivait
area.
Près de la rivière.
And he was put in the committee. It was that time
il a été nommé au sein
that
du comité,
I came to know
et
this
c'est à ce
person.
Moment-là que j'ai fait sa connaissance.
There is a person named
question.
Ban who has
une
testified that he was
Ban
on the Champkarlu District Committee and that he was an in-law of yours, the husband of one
et
of your cousins.
Qu'elle faisait partie
was this the same Ban who you were referring to?
C'était un de
the person
vos parents.
who is an in-law of yours and who married one of your cousins?
Qui s'était mariée avec l'un de vos cousins, qui faisait partie de vos beaux-parents, de votre belle famille?
Answer: no.
Réponse: non.
He was a villager and he was living close to a river area, and he was
rivière.
Not related by blood or by law.
Il n'avait aucun lien de
with
sang,
my
de
family.
Avec l'un des membres de ma famille.
Mr. President, with your leave, at this time I'd like to provide the witness statement
témoin,
of the individual I'm referring
si
to. It's document
E319/19.3.86.
Let me repeat, E319/19.3.86. I will not say the full name of this person because he is a proposed trial witness to TCW 950. He's someone who indicates in his statement that he is an in-law of the witness and that he served on the Champcarlu District Committee. I'd like to show the statement to the witness.
J'aimerais donc, si vous m'y autorisez, faire remettre ce document au témoin.
President, I have been informed that the witness is illiterate. She could not read and write.
Ni écrire.
May I ask whether, if she's unable to read the names that the perhaps
si
the
nom,
TPO person could assist her in order
TPO
to see if she can identify this person?
L'aider et voir si elle peut identifier cette personne.
President, yes, you may do so. Court officer, please work on that matter.
Huissier d'audience, veuillez vous en occuper, s'il vous plaît.
You could whisper to the witness, court officer.
Vous pouvez peut-être murmurer à l'oreille du témoin, monsieur l'huissier de danse.
Madam witness, I don't want you to read the name of this person, the
question,
full name
Madame
of this
le
person
témoin.
Out loud.
Je
I can tell you that this person also used a number of aliases, revolutionary aliases, one of which was Hoss and another Ho.
Ho.
Do you remember a person named Hoss or Ho who served with you on the Champcarlu District Committee and who was an in-law of yours, someone who married one of your cousins?
C'était quelqu'un qui se serait marié avec l'un de vos cousins, une de vos cousines, qui faisait donc partie de votre belle famille.
The bone.
Answer.
Réponse.
First, I heard the question about Taban. But now, the name Pos was mentioned to me.
Maintenant, vous venez de parler de Pos.
I knew this individual's name.
And j'ai connu cette personne.
We were related.
Et nous étions parents.
And is Pos someone who at some point served with you on the Champcarlu District Committee?
Fait partie du comité du district de Champcarlu à vos côtés à un moment donné?
Answer. I do not remember it.
Réponse.
I remembered that Ban was working with me.
Je me souviens que Ban travaillait avec moi.
And For the remainders of my colleagues, I do not recall them.
Mais je ne me souviens pas de mes autres collègues.
Let me ask you a general question about Chamkarlu district. Do you remember approximately how many people lived in that district during the Democratic Kampuchea period?
Answer. You mean the
réponse.
Population or you mean
vous
the members
de
of the committee?
Ou du nombre de membres
I
du comité?
Mean the population. What was the population of Chamkarlu district?
Quelle était la population du district de Chamkarlu?
Answer. I could not have the
réponse.
Full graph of the information. Because
je
I was not literate at that time, everything depended on the district secretary. I did not take note of of the population of that district.
Well, let's talk about your position. You've testified that in late 1975 you became a member of the Chamkarlu District Committee. Did you later become the secretary of that district, Chamkarlu?
Answer, I remain
réponse.
A member of that committee.
Je suis resté
committee.
Membre de ce comité.
As I stated earlier, I
comme
was
je l'ai déjà dit,
the member of that committee for
j'étais
one
membre
year.
De ce comité pendant
and later
un
on,
an.
I delivered
par
a
la
baby
suite,
and
j'ai
I was
eu
sick.
Un bébé, j'ai été malade.
I was in charge of female workers
who
worked at the dam site, but I was not with my workers constantly.
Madam Witness, I must tell you that a number of cadres close to you have testified that in late 1977, you became the secretary of Chamkarlu district. Let me read to you one of those references. And it comes from the document I just provided you, the testimony of your in-law, Ban or Pos. In answer 10 of his OCIJ interview E319/19.3.86, he testified as follows, quote, Sou Soeurn was appointed Chamkarlu District Secretary later, perhaps in late 1977. At that time, Un removed me from my position as the Sector 42 Commerce Chairman and appointed me as deputy to Sou Soeurn. End of quote. He has said the same thing in a number of interviews. Madam Witness, does this refresh your memory that you became the secretary of Chamkarlu district in late 1977 and that
POS
served as your deputy at that time?
Answer. I do
réponse.
Not recall it well because
je
I was not working with them.
Parce que je ne travaillais pas avec eux.
I may have forgotten
j'ai peut-être
it
oublié.
Because it has been a long time ago and my memory
cela
is being weak from day to day.
Et ma mémoire me fait défaut aujourd'hui.
In the quote I just read,
question.
Your in-law,
Ban
or Pos, referred to Un, a person named Un, who was the Sector 42 secretary after Toll.
Chef du commerce, secteur 42.
Was Un your biological brother?
Si Un était votre frère
and
biologique.
Is it correct that he became
si
sector secretary in 1977 after Toll?
Après Toll.
Answer. Un was my younger sibling.
Un était l'un de mes frères cadets.
He was my biological brother. He was
C'était mon frère biologique.
Appointed the secretary
Il a été
of
nommé
that sector
secrétaire de ce
that
secteur
year.
Cette année.
I, as I stated,
cette
I was working in that district
dis,
for a brief period of time, and because of my memory, I could
temps.
Not recall it all.
Mais je n'arrive pas à me souvenir de tout.
Madam witness, do you remember a cadre
Question.
Named
Madame
Chim,
témoin, vous souvenez-vous d'un cadre
who came from
Chim,
Takeo
qui venait de
in
Takeo,
the southwest zone?
De la zone sud-ouest.
And who was brought to the North Zone in 1977 and appointed chairman of the Chamkar Andong rubber plantation that was located in your district, Chamkar Lu. Do you remember Chim, this person who was brought in to be the head of the rubber plantation that was located in your district?
Answer, I do not recall it.
Réponse, je ne m'en souviens pas.
I do not remember all even my relatives and cousins, and how could I remember other people, and I did not know about the arrangement of the position for that particular individual.
Let me turn to some questions relating to the first January dam, Madam Witness. And I'm going to start with your son, Kapik Vanak's OCIJ interview, E3/35 at Khmer 00340563, English 00346149, French 00367721. He describes how in 1976 he was sent to study in Phnom Penh with a person named Pek Soka and another person he called Uncle Chai, alias Cham. Did you know these two people that your son studied with in Phnom Penh, named Cham and Pek Soka?
Answer. I know the two individuals, but they all deceased.
Mais ils sont tous deux morts.
Who was Cham?
Question. Qui était Cham?
Cham.
Answer.
Réponse.
Cham was the guy who worked with my husband.
Chai travaillait avec mon mari.
Is Cham someone who worked for your husband during the entire democratic Kampuchea regime?
Toute la période du Kampuchea démocratique?
Answer. He Réponse. Is deceased.
Il est décédé.
I understand that he is deceased. My question to you, is he someone who was close to your husband and worked with him throughout the entire Khmer Rouge regime.
A travaillé avec votre mari pendant toute la période du régime des Khmer Rouge.
Yes.
Réponse oui.
And did Cham have a role in supervising the construction of the first January dam?
Rôle de supervision de la construction du barrage du 1er janvier.
Answer. For this matter, I
Réponse.
Do not know. Cham was working for my husband. He was with my husband all the time, so I did not know about their business.
Et je ne savais rien de leurs affaires.
I am stating the truth. I will not tell anything that I do not know.
Je ne peux pas vous dire quelque chose que je ne sais pas.
Continuing in your son's OCIJ interview on the same pages of E335, this is what he testified that he did after he returned from his studies in Phnom Penh. Quote, question, after you finished your study, what did they have you do? Answer, I returned to Kampong Cham and accompanied my father to prepare a plan to build the first January dam. Question, in what year did they begin building the first January dam? Answer, the plan was developed since mid-1976. End of quote. My question for you, Madam Witness, do you know whether your husband had communications with and needed to obtain the approval of the party leaders in Phnom Penh in regards to the plan to build the first January dam?
I do not know about when the construction of the dam started and how long the construction lasted, as I was a female cadre. As I stated earlier, I was not with my workers constantly at that time. That is why I stated I do not know about this matter.
Let me ask you a general question about your husband. How often would he go to Phnom Penh for meetings?
Answer. I sometimes knew about his trips, and as I said, I live in Chom Ka Lo, and he was in Kampong Cham. When I went to see him, I would know about his business. I would know when he went to the meeting sometime, and as I told the court already, I sometimes did not meet him, you know, for a period of 3 months.
Je ne le rencontrais pas pendant une période qui pouvait aller jusqu'à 3 mois.
Did you ever accompany your husband on any of his trips to Phnom Penh?
Votre mari à l'un quelconque de ses voyages à Phnom Penh?
Answer. I never accompanied him to Phnom Penh.
Je ne l'ai jamais accompagné à Phnom Penh.
I went with other female cadres, and I, as I stated, I never went with him to Phnom Penh.
Une autre femme cadre, et comme je l'ai dit, je n'allais jamais à Phnom Penh.
I just want to clarify that last response. I'm not sure whether this was translation. Are you saying that you went to Phnom Penh once with a group of female cadres? Did I understand you correctly?
Answer. I went with female cadres.
Je suis allé avec des cadres femmes.
And we went to meet Nguyen Chi, and as I told you already, I never went to Phnom Penh with my husband, but with other cadres.
Could you please tell us about this time that you went to Phnom Penh with female cadres to meet with Nguyen Chi? Tell us what you remember about that.
Pourriez-vous nous dire ce dont vous vous souvenez à ce propos?
Answer. I do not recall it well now because it happened happened between 1970 and 1975. I do not remember the month that I was there to see
Nguyen Chi,
and I do not recall the date and the year exactly.
What was the reason that you went with this group of female cadres to meet
Nguyen Chi?
Answer. We went with a large group of cadres, hundreds of us. We were there to attend the political study sessions.
Nous sommes allés participer
and we were there to listen to the discussion about the arrangements of our workers in the cooperatives, and we were instructed to arrange properly the workers so that we could achieve a certain tons of rice per year. I was mentioning about the cadres, female cadres who were there with me and listened to the instruction at the time.
Aux côtés de cadres, femmes, nous écoutions ces instructions.
Thank you, Madam Witness. I may come back to this later. I was going to turn to another subject now, Mr. President. Do you wish me to continue, or this is the time for our morning break?
President, thank you. It is now the convenient time for a short break, and the chamber will take a short break from now until 10:30.
L'audience va être suspendue jusqu'à 10h30.
Court officers, please assist the witness in during the break time, and please invite this witness and TPO staff back to the courtroom at 10:30. The court is now in recess.